This is Games with Frank, and welcome to another video. It's been a while since I actually uploaded a video on YouTube, and that's because I was working on my Udemy course. And today we'll be looking forward to how to integrate the new shader graph that came out with Unity 2018 with the PlayMaker, and how exactly you can use it with PlayMaker. So first off, you just need to make sure that you just created a new project and follow the process that I am going to be showing you. So I have PlayMaker imported and I have a sample scene over here. And first thing I need you to do is go to Window and open up Package Manager. Now this Package Manager is what exactly we need to import shader graph as well as the pipeline asset which is integrated with that. So go down, as you can click on all, and you can see all the packages that are available from the Unity server. And here's post-processing, and what we need is shader graph. Just hit on install and that would basically install shader graph. Shader graph is in project, and now we will go to all and go to lightweight render pipeline and hit on install. You need to go to assets and create rendering, create rendering lightweight pipeline asset, and then just leave it like that. Now go to edit, project settings, graphics, and then put this down to there. Now you can go to edit, render pipeline, upgrade project materials. So now if I create a material, you can see that it is creating a material in lightweight pipeline instead of standard. The standard looks like it's buggy, but you know, it has been replaced by the thing that we used, which is lightweight pipeline asset. So we'll delete that new material, and we'll just create a folder for materials, and we'll create a material over here. We'll call this shader material, and we'll create a shader, a PBR graph, since these are the coding shaders and I don't know how to code. So the shader graph that Unity introduced is like treasure for me. So you just go to shader and PBR graph, you just create that and name it shader graph or something. And now you can see this. You can open the shader editor, and this is the shader graph editor window. So once you open that, you land here. And what we need to do, what we are going to do in this tutorial, is basic and very simple. We'll just go over here and create a vector 1, and basically vector 1 is nothing but a float in a shader graph. So I'll just name that variable, something like that. You can name it anything, and the default, I'll just set it to 0. And I'll drag it over here. That will basically put that variable over here, and I'll just connect this one with alpha. Make sure that this surface is set to transparent, and once you do that, you can make it 0 and you can see that it's becoming invisible. So that's basically what we want. I don't know, this is basically a a bug or something. See that? And I just saved this asset by clicking on save asset, and you can exit this. Since you have the variable stored, you can just quit. And what we need to do here is put a shader graph, which we just created, and here we can see compiled code. We are not going to code in this, but we will be taking some input from the code and putting it in PlayMaker. So basically I'll just compile that, and you can see that there is this particular variable float, the name of the variable and the property of the variable and its value. All these three are given, as well as the name of this particular variable. So we need this one, so I'll just right click and copy and just close this window. Now I'll go to PlayMaker. I'll just create a sphere or something like that, and I'll use this particular. And before going into that, you just go to the shader material that we created and go to graphs and make it shader graph. The shader graph is the name of the graph that we created. So this one, just drag it into the sphere that we have in the scene. Just reset its position and let's add a PlayMaker FSM to this sphere. And what I want to do is set material float, and by that it means that we can control floats, which are variables of a particular material. So I'll just go to material and tell which material is this. So this is shader material, and the name float, we just copied it, we'll just paste it over here and put its value to a variable. I'll just call this float and keep it every frame. Now what I will do with this float is ease it from 1 to 0. From its value. Let's say 5 seconds. That will give us enough time to see. So I'll just hit play and test whether this particular shader graph FSM is working. Okay, this float has been set to 0, so just change the default value of the float for 1 instead of 0, and that will make it vanish in 5 seconds. So that's basically how you use shader graph along with PlayMaker.